I feel happy. I'm live. Look, I feel happy. Thank you. Thank you, Savage. You know, I don't even know your real name, but thank you. Thank you, Savage. That was really nice. You know what? I don't know if I ever would have thought that you and I would come together on a live, and chat about my friend Megan, my ex-friend Megan, who I thought was going to be my friend for life. Honestly, I really did. I never would have sent her a t-shirt if she wasn't going to be my friend for life. Hello, my dear. Hello, my darling. Thank you. I feel so good after that. Oh my God, that was so nice. Yes, we do. We object to bullshit. Hey, Bob, thanks for your nice comments. Guys, you leave me such some wonderful comments. She's funny. Yeah, I enjoyed her. We relate on more levels than I thought. I didn't even know, but because she used to not like Ernie and I don't know, you know, Jimmy. Hindsight. Thanks, guys. She really made me in a better mood. I really appreciate that about her. I love that she saw my efforts were to benefit my friend, even though I was got really upset, you know, and I really appreciate that she understood where my heart was and not, you know, what PCT was trying to turn me into this horrible person, you know. Like I was this evil person for wanting. It's like there's two kinds of people in the world. You know, the people that want you, that understand the mother codes, and people that don't. And, you know, she let me talk. She let me talk. I was, thanks. Thanks for coming over. That was really nice. I really enjoyed that interview. It put me in a good mood, made me feel so much better. She just was very gracious and kind and let me talk. And she's a fan, which is nice. She likes my rants. Look, anybody who likes my rants, we're going to be like this. So I hope you sum me up. And yeah, I really like the fact that they believe in the mother and visiting your mom. I mean, this is really like, I'm like, okay, this is where we understand each other. This is an important thing to understand. So she was very nice. She made me feel really good. And I really appreciate that because I felt pretty bad the last couple of days. I was like hiding under the covers yesterday, so traumatized by the things that PCT was saying about me and my mom and lying, direct lies. I never said she didn't have a stroke. I never said that. Hi, Julie. I said that I thought she had an extra stroke. Hey, Tony. Ashley, good to see you, honey. Aw, thank you, sweetheart. That's really sweet. Hey, Rainey. Hi, Joe. Yes, we object to bullshit. And we all need to get the, I got to get the shirts out there, guys. I'm wondering if the company that I'm working with, I need to make a grilled cheese sandwich. I feel like celebrating. You guys want to see the snow? Look. See the snow? Yeah. And her mother. And her mother. You know, I just didn't realize that she did not, she has no intention of seeing her mom. And she's going to pretend. It's all an act. I didn't realize. This is like a real exercise. And thank you, Jackie. I do feel better. I feel so much happier. And Savage's, her picture is really a good picture because her eyes, you just stare into her eyes like it's really her. And she's talking behind this picture and her eyes are looking directly at you. It's a really good picture. I need a picture where you, I look like, you know what I mean? Thank you, hon. Thank you. Oh, I adore you too, honey. You are so cute and talented. Lean on me. So cute. I know when you like, when you love my rants, I know we're going to get along. Hey, Alan, you want me to check my mail? I will. Thank you. Lean on me. You're so cute. I don't even know your first name either. Thank you, Whitney. Good to see you guys. Hi, Sunshine. Marbella. Thank you, hon. That's really sweet. You only get one mother. Here, I spend as much time with both parents as I possibly could. That's nice, Bob. I'd like to get to know you better, Bob. You seem like a good man. I like men who are good. You know, just good men. You know, nice, good men. Just like the old-fashioned kind of good guys. I like those guys. That's what my mom found in Maine. Jam 420, you look beautiful today. Thank you. I had a really nice interview with Savage Lives Media. She understands me. She understands. She's Team Rose. So, hey, St. Elmo's Fire. So that felt really good. Queen Widow. Personally, she says, personally, I don't care for PCT. She never loves others talking. She always makes things about her. I know. And she's making everything about her. The fact that she was making the thing that happened with Ernie and him trying to solve a problem with, you know, a creator, another guy, or not even whatever. And she's making that about her. She will make everything about her. She's just like my little sister. That was nice of Savage to let me go on, you know. Look how my grays. Look how my hair, my grays. Look how gray my hair is, guys. It's like a lot of gray, a lot of white, a lot of blonde. Anyway, she was really nice. And I really appreciate that. Who would have thought? You know, you never know. But, yeah. She's good. She's a good woman if she understands this and is taking the side of heart, the mother love, you know? Thank you, Tony. Bella Ann, good morning, sweetheart. Good morning, sidekick. Good to see you. I am. I feel so much better, guys. I feel so much better. She let me talk. It was one-on-one. It was just me and her. I didn't have to deal with this giant panel of people attacking me. Saying, yeah, why'd you say this? And why'd you say that? It's like, there's a bigger picture here. There's a lot of goodness. And I also am glad she supported me on getting that shirt back. I'm glad she understood that. Oh yeah, she's playing everyone. She does know what she's doing and she is a good actress. She is a damn good actress. This is all an act. And Joe was just starting to figure it out. You know, I'll never be able to talk to Joe. I'll never be able to have a relationship with Joe because little Miss Trauma, little Miss Papa Bust a Gasket, Miss Lawsuit. So Joe is just as constricted and so am I. I don't care if you marry him. Obviously you do. You're just afraid that he's going to tell me the truth about you, little hooker. The thing is that Joe probably doesn't actually want somebody bashing the mother of his son, because I know that's a thing where, you know, you can say something about your ex, but you don't want other people to say something about your ex. And I learned that from my mom too, my mother. It was nice. It was really nice. Pamela. Yeah. We all lost the wrench. Don't worry. Even though everybody lost it, there's no wrenches in here, right? See, right? There's no wrenches. Everybody, I had to just clean the slate, guys. Just so, even Maria, I will be giving wrenches back. Don't worry. I take them away, I give them back, take them away, I give them back. You have to earn them every day. Don't worry, guys. It's nothing personal. Everybody lost them. Thank you. Thanks, Joe. It feels good to laugh and smile. I was really triggered. I was very upset. I was traumatized. I was crying. I was, thank God. And Savage Lives really helped me. Offering me a place to talk, and I change, you know, whatever. It's the first day of spring. The world is, my world's covered with snow. You know, I was able to take a shower and refresh myself enough to uplift. And she was really nice. She understands where I'm coming from, which means everything. She's Team Rose. She dances, you know. In a way that isn't going to get her in trouble. Thank you. Yeah, and then there's the roses from Richard, which I have to show you. Hey, Chaos and Roses, you are... It went well. It was nice. It made me feel good. She made me feel good. I was really... It was good. I should wear my stone. You are very smart. And all of your comments in Steffers... You know what's going on. I'm very impressed with you. You really are amazing. You know, maybe we'll do an interview because you're a farmer. You know what it means to grow food. You know what it means to survive off the land. You know what's going on with the border. You know what's going on with Americans not working. And then it's everybody else. And it's the, you know, people coming over the border. They're getting the jobs, even though this country was founded on immigrants. I mean, we're all immigrants. But yeah, your comments were amazing and you really do know your shit. And you've lived it. I have a lot of respect for you. And I wanted to tell you that. And I was listening, but I was so knocked off my feet by this whole thing with PCT that I didn't have the energy. That kind of stuff really sets me back. And also PCT, she'll never let anybody get a word in edgewise. She will shut everyone up. She will override everyone and make it all about her and her details. She controls everything and no one can stop her. Except the only way to stop her, guys, is to take her off, either mute her or take her off the panel so you can talk and then bring her back up. I actually did that a couple times. I took her all the way off the panel. There was no shutting her up. You cannot shut that woman up. It is impossible. It is impossible. And she'll just have, before you know it, you are roped into yet more whatever. And she's incredible at doing that. I hear what she does, how she controls, how she uses her voice to control, control with her clicks and her speech and her numbers. Counting 50, always putting out these numbers. That's all control. She is a master manipulator. She's a covert narcissist in action. She will suck the life out. She will take and yet create this. She will suck your energy while spinning her tails of woe. She does get the acting award. You were there. I'll have to go back and watch the comments. I didn't see any of the comments. You just dropped off your mom. She was there here for a month. She'll be back in a month. Oh, that's nice. I miss my mom. Thanks. It does feel good to thank you. I thought it was good too. She really was nice to me. She really let me grab. Hold on. She really was very, very nice. Very gracious. She's Team Rose. You gotta love her. You gotta love her for that. She's Team Rose. You gotta love her for that. There, here's my nice pendant. We can all have some crystal magic. I'd give everybody a free t-shirt if, you know, I could afford it. I would, you know. You know, right? Don't you want one of these? The infamous coveted t-shirt. Yeah, I want my t-shirt. Because I don't want her to have it because she doesn't deserve it. She's not a good friend and she doesn't object to bullshit. She perpetuates bullshit. And that is a fact. We Scottish Tiger. Gosh, good to see you. Some people get mad at you. Gosh, I saw my sister's voice. Good to see. There's a lot of people. How many people are in the chat? I saw 700 people in the chat. So that was on the watching. So that's a lot. Was there that many people watching? Did anybody notice how many people were watching? Thank you. It feels good to smile. I was really down. I was really, really down. I was knocked off my feet. I couldn't function for 2 days. I even had two bookings for my place I just completely didn't even see. And I didn't even see them until they'd expired. That's pretty bad. Thorpes. Thank you, honey. I do have the best chat. I agree with you. Yep. She's like, it's your fault that I showed these horrible parts of myself where I wish that you'd choke on your food and that you would have sleepless nights filled with anxiety and that you would, whatever she wished upon me, you know, that it was my own fault if something happened to my grandchild. You know, those aren't people that, see, well, you have a friend. It's like, it's one thing to fight about stuff and then work it out, but to go after cops. Okay. First of all, you call the cops on me or you involve cops, our relationship is over. Okay. That's just how I feel. I feel like if somebody's going to call law enforcement on me or involve guys with guns to work out civil problems, and those cops that she called, they were like, this is a civil case. And then she was like, I'm going to sue her for everything she's worth, everything she's got. If I have a stroke, an imaginary stroke that I'm going to make up. Ernie's doing amazing things. That's awesome. Dolly? I mean, if he can be. Every guy wants to be a player, baby. Oh, Queen Widow. I thought it was sweet though. Queen Bee tried to let you both use her platform. Yeah, I don't want to be up there to wither. Hi, Deb Vlogs. She's going to wake up in rage. Is she asleep? I thought she was there. Was she there or not there? It was earlier. We just did it. I'm winning. I'm winning because, I mean, I'd love to have my shirt back. That's a loss. That matters. I mean, she manipulated me into sending it. I didn't really want to send it to her. It's their clothes I wear. You know, I wear size medium and size large, depending on how big my boobs are that day, because they change, you know? You know what's making me feel happy is you guys, because right before that interview, I was reading some of the comments that you guys leave, and I love it when you leave me comments. I love it when you leave me nice comments. I did have to delete somebody who said something really mean about how if you get this emotional, no wonder your siblings took your mother from you. What kind of fucking statement is that? No matter how emotional I get, my mother wants to see her daughter. And my mother's glad that I'm emotional about her. You think separating me from an old... See, that's a sick person. By the way, you will not be commenting on my page again. I blocked you and your stupid comment because you're an idiot. And people who say, think that the elderly needs to be removed from their emotional daughter because her emotional daughter is emotional because she separated from her mother. That's the kind of denial. Look, there's something called denial spirits. I'm kind of surprised that in a way they want me to be friends. Hold on a second. I have to grab something. Hold on a second, guys. I mean, the reason you don't say win or lose. Here's where there's winning. Some people have told me that because of this whole thing, they've gone to see their mom and their grandparent, you know, and that's a good thing, you know? So that's a win for the older people. I worked at a nursing home and there were many that didn't get visits. That's the thing. My mom did not want to be in a nursing home and I wanted to give her what she wanted. Well, you did. You're very, very smart. You're a very smart woman. You know a lot. I really have a lot of respect for you. Chaos and Roses. I don't remember your first name, but I have a lot of respect for you. And I think that your words should be taken seriously because you know what the hell's going on. You do. Right from the inside out, you really do know what's going on. And you're living it. You're living on a farm. This is how we live. Or, you know? Yeah, when she's on a panel, it's all about her. There's no way anyone will ever get to say anything. Ever. And then I have to be... Anyway, I like one-on-one. No, they're not. Where's she going to get the money? If I have another stroke. And I'm so good at acting like I had one. But to me, she had one before she said that because she was acting weird, you know? Oh yeah, she's not at all. I wouldn't be surprised if she was, you know, she's either been put out to pasture or she's a slick spy or she's, I'm telling you, this is an actress. This is an actress. And then her body being in shape like that. It's like she's a ninja. You know what I mean? It's like she's a hitman. I don't know. She could be a sleeper cell. That's sad. I really wanted to be there at every holiday. And when I went to Thanksgiving, this unbearable alone, nobody would show up. And it was just me again alone with my mom. And the food was the worst food you've ever seen. Thank you. She was really gracious to me. I feel very appreciative. She put me in a good mood. I really appreciate her. And I know she doesn't like Ernie. She doesn't like She doesn't like Jimmy. But I'm not going to worry about those things because you look at like you have one mom, and I always say that you're going to regret it if you don't visit your parents when they sadly pass. Yeah, that's why I went and visited my dad for this week when he was getting older and he had cancer, and I could tell his time was limited. And I went and stayed with him for a week, and he was living on his boat in Florida. And thank you. I do. And I'm not crazy. And I mean, why would I to believe that I would lie about money like that? It's like, that's a big lie, you know? And why are you accusing me of lying? You know, don't you know me better than that? You think out of the blue I'm lying just because I want you to go see your mother? Like, she really doesn't want to go see your mother. She really doesn't want to go. You couldn't watch Grace anymore? What does that mean? Who's Grace? Yeah, she didn't let PJ. Yeah, she basically said, I don't respect PJ. She doesn't. I think she's really trying to destroy Dolly's relationship with PJ in any way she can. And she also wants to get clicks and views. And she wants it to seem like she's got this secret. Why doesn't Dolly come up and say something? Dolly. I hope you didn't. Although you gotta wonder, because it's like, does he like to keep a door open? I mean, what? Why wouldn't she come clean with the truth? I don't think they saw each other. I just don't know. I think that what I understood was that he told her that if he flies out there, everyone's gonna call her a slut. And I think he told her that. And thanks for being here, guys. It's nice. Let me do my hair and makeup in the middle of my show. No, Savage was very nice, and it really helped me feel better. And I needed that. I needed that. Now PCT's going to want to get up there and go on and twist it. And I know her tactic. She is a genius. She is a genius at manipulating. She is top of the line, guys. They are breaking the PO because he is living on a different floor. What? Wrench free. Thank you, hon. Yeah, it's just for now. It's just for now to see how it goes. It's, you know, the Maria, I'm going to give, and probably Catelyn, because they understand that I don't like people timed out. And only I'll give you guys wrenches back, but it's only if you need to share something. And sometimes it's okay to just, like, let's talk, you know? Yeah. It's nice to have wrenches so that you can tell if somebody's real or fake. There's that. Thank you. If you hang out with me without a wrench, then you're truly Team Rose. You're true Team Rose. Hashtag true Team Rose. It's my new thing. If I write true Team Rose to you, that means I think that you, and I'm going to make a t-shirt that says true Team Rose, right? Because that means you're really Team Rose. You're really somebody that does object to bullshit as opposed to spinning bullshit, pretending. She took my shirt. She wanted that for free. I didn't want to give her that shirt. She kept pressuring me. You know, I didn't really. She did ask and ask and ask and ask. She asked and asked and asked. She doesn't her diction. She uses the, she's very good diction, like an actor. Like an actress. She's like an actress. She probably loves that. She looks like an actress. She reminds me of Lucille Ball, Mary Tyler Moore with her high pitched voice, right? Joe, Mary Tyler Moore. Betty Davis. But, and then Jackie Onassis a little bit, just like that style. I don't know. But she is a master manipulator. Thanks. They are, and they're really soft, and they're really comfortable, and they're flattering. You know, they kind of hide your belly, you know, and they're racer back, And, you know, which is, I like, race her back, right? I don't know if the tag is there or whatever, but race her back. Race her back is nice because if you have, I find that race her back bras are the most uplifting for my old magical boobs. Magical boobs. I also am going to have one that says magical boobs, hashtag Team Rose, right? Magical boobs, hashtag Team Rose. You just watch the start over on Savages, but I will catch the whole replay. As far as what I've seen, Rose Bravo, Roby, I just love you. Thank you. I had a nice time over there. I have to. She was very gracious, and she put a smile on my face, and she gets some bennies for that. Bennies are benefits. I'm not a dark witch. I was trying to help PCT the whole fucking time. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks, Bam Bam. PCT is the reason you haven't been around in a while. Really? Wow. I have to avoid her now too. I mean, I cannot handle her voice now. And I used to really like it, you know? And there's this person I'm not allowed to mention. I liked his voice, but I wasn't even allowed to hear it very much before the war started. And I thought we were going to have like a funny cake war. Like let's have cake battles. Like who makes the best cake? I didn't realize it was going to turn into this really ugly, you know, slander against me and my family, bad mouthing my son, bad, you know, threatening my grandson, all this shit, making me have fake porn sites and stuff that I wasn't expecting. I thought we were going to have a cake off. I thought we were going to have a cutesy little fun bake off, cake off, not, you know, this ugly battle where my personal family is dragged and slagged and horrible, horrible rumors are said. Disgusting things. Like, why would you want friends like that? You know, if they get mad at you, they turn you into this, they do all this terrible stuff. It's like, I really needed a break from all the screaming and all the, with the panels with a million people all yelling over each other. And then PCT controls the whole fucking thing. She wins every single fucking time. PCT will win. And she will be talking. Let me finish. Let me finish. I just want to say, just let me finish. How come that she always gets her way? And everyone's just finally is like, and then she's bawling. Oh, I'm such a victim. Oh, they're so mean to me. That is exactly what my little sister would say. Oh, she's so mean to me. You're all so mean to me. You're 60 fucking one. She acts like she's four. I'm not a two-year-old. No, you're a four-year-old. Not a two-year-old. You're four. Daddy. Daddy. Oh, she and her playing the victim with me. Hey, Dollar. See how no one has a wrench? No one. Hey, BH. Good to see you, Nani. Thanks. I do feel refreshed. And you guys help me so much. I'm going to message PJ and just say, you know, thank you. When you don't care about the wrench, then I'm going to write wrenchless magical boobs. How about that for a t-shirt? You are so smart. You know a lot. You know a lot. And you've been there and you have raised kids. You're an adult. You know, I really like people like you, high quality people like you who know what the fuck is going on in real life. You're not just a, you're out there picking blueberries. I mean, you're growing and you have a farm. That's the real deal. You're the one that's going to survive this bitch. Need wrench drop links for Team Rose Speaks Her Truth. Oh, so what is that? And also, the reason Steffers, well, yeah, Steffers was really supportive of me too. Like after this whole bashing thing at night, I was over at Steffers, but I was still like, I get knocked off my feet by this shit. When people attack me and my mom, That knocks me off, and it is over after that. It is war, and it is over after that, you know. And then Steffers was on there supporting me. And it was really, really nice to hear her voice saying, understanding me, and thank you. God, Steffers. Yeah, I'll give everybody's wrenches back eventually. I'm Marie Mariachi. She'll be managing Mod along with Kat Lynn, probably. Because Kat's really good at grabbing, and so is Maria. They're both really good at getting links when you need them, doing research instantly. Right now, it's okay to just... The other thing was, guys, if you really can't stand a certain person, here's your chance to block that person without taking them away from the whole channel. So this is a nice opportunity for that, too. 222, thanks for being here, guys. Look, 222. 222. I wish I could take a picture of that. I wonder if I can take it before the number changes. And I hate that guy that I'm not allowed to speak about. Look. Oh, it changed anyways. That's okay. That's okay. I like lazy mods. That's what I want, a lazy mod. Except for if somebody is really, really fast and good at it. Kat is like, bam. And she'll look up who's fake, who's real. Maria's really good too. And everybody's going to get their wrench back of it. She's an energy vampire. That is what she is. She is. She's a witch. Her son said so. She's very mean to PJ with her whole, I'm not telling. I'm not saying. All I'm saying is I'm happy. And that's all I'm going to say. My lips are sealed. Come over to my channel and see if I'll spill something. You know? She is the biggest manipulator I've ever met in my life. She's sucking the good out of you, and I object. Thank you. She also brings out the worst in me. But she takes everything. Oh, you brought up you because of you. I said horrible things. No, PCT. All you had to say was, you know what, Rose? You have no business talking to me like this. I'm really upset with you. My mother and my is none of your freaking business. And I'm hanging up on you now. I'm not. She didn't have to drag me for 2 weeks. You know? So rude. She's so controlling. Yeah. Hi, sweetie. Hi, Richard. Mwah. Richard. Richard, Richard, Richard. You are so sweet. I loved your card. I loved your card. Yeah. I would love to have you on panel sometime really soon if you want to and talk about what's going on. And you do freaking know. And you are very cool. And you know what's going on. We need to hear from you more. We need to hear from you. Let's set up something. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. She's going to rewrite history, reframe everything, take everything I said, act like the victim, pretend that she was attacked. She lies about me publicly every fucking night. And I don't always see it. And then sometimes I see it. And, you know, I was watching Easy. Now, he's really good friends with Mel from the UK. Not our Mel, but her, that Mel. So that Mel doesn't like me. So I don't think that he feels like he can ever be on my side or say anything nice about me. And then I feel bad, too, because there's this other guy who's on her panel. And actually, Mel covers really interesting topics. I will give her that. And, you know, I don't really have anything against her, no matter what. But, I mean, she does do interesting topics sometimes. But... You know, she's so against me that that's not a cool thing, you know. So this guy might not be willing to come and talk to me and us, though I wanted him to share his insights on numerology and the multiverse. He's this really interesting guy. And I wanted to have him on my panel. And but then I thought she'd probably kill him. I don't know. Not kill him, but you know what I mean. It's a figure of speech. Now she busted. Now she busted. When PCT danced with Ernie on panels several weeks ago, and she played dumb to the butt plug. I saw what she was then in the I'm an airhead act. I know. Exactly, that is exactly what she does. That is what my sister did. She was either. She managed to act like I was doing something to her when I wasn't. and always looking for a way to make it look like my fault or I was bad, and then cry. Oh God, the crying is, it's masterful. It's masterful. The crying she did last night or the one that she did on, she was on QB, Queen B, but it was Speakeasy who was covering it and showing, when I saw the way she was, people are so mean. You know, this, oh my, like, oh, wow, she is getting everybody's sympathy, even though she doesn't deserve it, but she's getting it because she's crying so perfectly. This is a genius. She's a genius. And Joe has been fucked over by this genius because he really loved her and probably still does. And she's the biggest victim. My sister and PCT would have a very tough competition on biggest victim in the room. And my ex's second wife too. She would be right up there, the three of them. PCT and my sister can manufacture the tears though. And the tantrums, oh God. I don't know who would win. It would really be tough. The other one, the second wife, she's really good at acting like the victim, but in a different way. She doesn't cry. She writes sob stories. This woman is a master manipulator. And she was so good at getting everybody to automatically hate me. I guess who doesn't love their mother? Because other people were like, look, I don't think your messages were even that bad. You know, to be like, you know, you were just trying to get her to go see her mom. And anyways, I'm really happy that I had that nice talk with her because I needed somebody to talk with that wasn't trying to attack me, you know, and then let that bitch up there. I'm sorry, but she is not in my good graces at all. Send me my shirt back and we'll talk about it. I want my shirt back and then I'll consider talking to you and seeing if I can even be ever again on panel with you or anything. Otherwise, without you sending me my shirt back, I am absolutely never speaking to you again. It broke my heart when PCT wasn't allowing anyone to really speak. PJ couldn't talk. Even PCT wouldn't let Rose talk either. I know. I left Ollie's page because she would not allow others to talk. Yeah. Yeah. And I think that Queen B should have dropped Papercut down and let PJ speak. And just because you cannot shut Papercut up. The only way to shut her up is to take her off the panel, put her down in the thing. So she's still there. You can bring her back up. That is the only way to stop her, is to literally take her off panel and let somebody else talk. Otherwise, she will do all the talking, and that's the way it is, and it will never be any other way. Yeah, she would not be. She will not be quiet. She will control everything. She will make it all about her. She will keep on talking. There, no one has a chance when she's up there. It is the PCT show, and it will always be the PCT show, the poor me PCT show. That's what it's going to be. If she has the chance. Yes. Yes, she is. She is. It is. That was so nice to have a one-on-one. It was so nice to see another woman understand. That was just so nice. I mean, and it made me feel good. And it made me feel happy. Thank you. Thank you, Savage Lost. Who would have thought I'd be, you and I would have a nice chat and be laughing. And you're like, I'm Team Rose. And I'm, thank you, girl. Let's dance. You know, you want to be on my dance off team? She doesn't give a shit about PJ. That's true. Shelly Matung. Wow. Hello, my dear. Oopsie. Sorry. Sorry. Hello, my dear. Straw was when she called me a troll on Dolly's page, and I've been following him since the island. Oh, wow. Wow. Yes. Let me show it to you up close. I know I'm behind. I always am. Look. Isn't that gorgeous? This is what, I got this from Dan. He made this. He's amazing. He also made this. I've known Dan for years. He's a local jeweler. He's a local crystal guy, and um, I'm not a fan of the dumb, coy bit of hers. It's utter BS. It is. Good morning, Mike. Good morning, pretty sweet pea. Yeah, it is. I mean, yeah, we got to get the shirts online. I've got to call that guy. Should I call him now? You make her be quiet. If you're a man. Oh, Ernie has total control over her. And so does Jimmy. Jimmy and Ernie are the ones who can control this woman. She will do nothing I want. She'll just call me and make me sound like I'm some horrible person. Ernie can snap his fingers. She will do whatever he wants. Same with Jimmy. But Jimmy doesn't want that power that we know of. I don't know why Jimmy doesn't go online. He did it to me. He said, Team Rose, come on, you're a stalker. We don't have any special event. I was like, whatever, Jimmy. I still stuck around just because I was that desperate for a friend but then Jimmy would talk to me in code. Because I said, you got to talk to people in code sometimes, Jimmy. And he started to talk to me in code. And there were times that Jimmy would really let me know that he had my back. And that, you know, and I understood that his weird little position in the world with the weird, you know, him and you want, I want you to have one. What do you think, Maria? PCT saying, I'm saying, go see your mother. And she says, I hope you choke. And I'm saying, go see your mother. I'm going to kill you if you don't go see your mother. And she says, I hope you die. I hope you have sleepless nights. And what was the other thing? I'm going to cut up all your stuff. Go see your mother. I'm destroying your gifts. Go see your mother. I think that'd be funny. There were 700. That's a lot. Is that her normal? It's probably not as much as that. Or was that normal for her? Thank you. Wait till I show you this, the ones that Richard gave me. I'll show you. You want to see those? Thank you, Shanae. Thank you. It was good. I felt really happy and enjoyed myself. And it was just nice to be able to talk. And she was very cool and very nice and very gracious. And the thing about her is that she is going to continue going on panel after panel after panel, lying about me, shit-talking me, acting like the victim, because I'm telling the truth about her. This is my perception. She doesn't have to talk about me, you know? And I would be sad to lose me as a friend, too. I'm a good friend. I will stand by you. I've always been loyal to Jimmy and Ernie. I mean, I decide whether I like you, and then I like you, you know? This is a really strange thing. Because there was a couple of times, to be honest with you, and I am honest, I don't even have to say that, but she says that a lot. There were times I wondered if she really did want me as a friend or if she thought I was some kind of weird threat or something and that she wasn't understanding that I really wanted to be her friend and that I was her friend, that I was on her side. I felt like she was like, ooh, Team Rose, I don't know. I'm actually the first one she saw. And then she saw my channel first, and then she went over to Jimmy's and made herself into that. She didn't really follow me. She saw whatever I did, and then she just copied me. And then she went over to Jim Ernie's. She just did everything I did. Then I was dancing. She started dancing. She just does everything I do. It's really weird. Yeah, you should definitely have a We Objected bullshit t-shirt, Marion. I want you guys... If I had a higher voice, I'd be able to imitate her better. She does. She has to spin it to be the victim. That's exactly what my sister does. And they're very, very, both of them are very good at it. Ooh, you're making focaccia? It is devastating when we're betrayed. Max Spear said, birth, betrayal, death, rebirth. And that's the matrix we've been stuck in. That's the pain of betrayal. And it has. It goes on and on. Yeah. You know what she also reminds me of is Blanche in Streetcar Named Desire, Alan. What do you think about that? Blanche, you know, seducing the husband and creating all this drama and crying and just being, she would have been a great Blanche if she was an actress. Thank you, Nicolina. That's nice. I finally feel like a normal person. I do. I agree. Thank you. I feel like she helped too. You know, I mean, this could go on and on, but it was just really nice to have somebody who isn't me have a one-on-one with me about this and just be a supportive friend. It was really nice. Or just act like a girlfriend, you know? It was really, really nice. I'm really happy she has the mother codes. That makes me very happy. That's why I felt like I could have a conversation with her, because I heard that she and her friend were both like, damn, 12 years, see your mother. You go get on and see your mother right now, you know? It's like, yeah, it's running out, because 83, you've just lost a year. You know, once you get into 83, time is running out. That's a fact. Most people don't live over 100, and most people don't live to 90. My mother died at 88, and that was a long time. She was going down at 82. That's when they started to go down. Now, she was going way down. I managed to pick her up and hold her together for 2.5 years steady, and then she was taken away, put in a nursing home, and disappeared and died because of the horrible treatment. You people that think that it was a good idea to separate my mother and I, you are the soulless, heartless ones that have no soul. Hey, Attacor, good to see you, hon. Yeah, it was nice. Thank you. It was really nice. It was transformative, and it is the first day of spring. It was a nice way to bring in spring. She's Team Rose, so hopefully she'll get a shirt and we can all wear Team Rose, We Object to Bullshit t-shirts and have a little dance do a dance routine, you know, one of those group dance routines, you know. I had this idea of having this song, which would hopefully be an original song, because I do write songs sometimes. Not like I'm a songwriter, but, you know, like for special events. And then people who want to can take like 8 counts or 16 counts and make up some choreography, and then we'll do one person's choreography for 16, another and another, and then build the whole routine and then do this whole routine. You know, I've had a fantasy of that for a long time, and that would be so fun to do with all of us on my channel. I know a lot of people do not like We Scottish. I don't know who she is. She's always been nice to me. Thank you, sweetie. I don't even believe they were really cops. Wait, really? Ernie hasn't been on this morning. He was on. So he was on Queen Bee. That sounds delicious, Katie. Thank you. That's nice, because I don't like to always cam up. Oh, the video was savage. Do you want the link to that? Hold on, I'll put the link in. Here it is. Here it is. It's nice. She only has 62 likes. Here it is. Here it is, guys. And I will be giving wrenches back and stuff like that. It was nice. It was at 10 o'clock. I was available. I was, you know, because I think that Queen Bee wanted to do one with me, but I wasn't able to get there or something. And then I think she wanted to do something like at 4:30, and I didn't see it till 7. So I was like, oh, I missed that. I didn't even get a chance, because I would do a one-on-one with Queen Bee. I don't really feel comfortable having a whole panel of hers going after me at once, because but I mean, if she wanted to do one-on-one, I would. She's definitely, you know, Team Tina in a way. Thank you, guys. You guys, you know, honestly, your messages this morning, I was reading some of your messages. They helped me so much, because I was like, I want to be in a good place to do this interview. I don't want to be all edgy and like, you know, like triggered, ease like on the verge of bawling and everything. And I was really, really triggered by the whole thing. Made me very, very upset. So to feel like I got through it and I was able to emerge on time to do this interview and have it be a good, positive experience, I really appreciate that. And I will always be appreciative to her for that. It was really nice of her, you know, to give me that nice she was very gracious and very sweet and very nice. And she totally understood me. It was really, thank you. Thank you, Savage. What's her first name? I don't know anybody's first name. I know Katie's first name. And your messages, guys, I just wanted to tell you, thank you so much. You have helped me so much. You have no idea. The bad stuff is awful. The sun's starting to come out. And it's really, but you guys that are supporting me are, oh my goodness, thank you. I mean, I love you guys, and I'm going to bless you. You will be blessed. Thank you, honey. Thank you for bringing out the best in me, guys. Maria G, the best mod. She is the top mod. Don't steal her. You can have her, but not as much as I get her. She used to be both me and Paper Cut's top mod, except for Kat Lynn, but Kat Lynn doesn't show up all the time. Maria's pretty much been there. She does a lot. Love you too, Tony Pony. Oh, thank you. I'll have to go back and watch it. I wonder if anybody streamed it. I really learned who this woman is. And the only reason I'm able to understand this type of personality is because of my sisters. Otherwise, I'd never understand. And then I would even say that she is almost, I'm in there too. She's like a combination because of the actor stuff. But she's not an actress, but she is a performer in her own way. It's all an act. My sister is all an act too. Incredible. Incredible. B. Ogden. I actually left Dolly's channel because PTC need for attention. Wow. And I was following PCT on her attention thing, and then it ended up just turning into this. I guess maybe part of her didn't want me as a friend. I really am still. Oh, she's been gone 30 years. Wow. Mine's been gone 3.5 years. And I still miss my mommy. I love my mom. I love my mama. She was such a good, strong woman, you know. And I felt like she's been with me, and I was really with my mother. I mean, we were together every second of every day. There were the people that supported me were other people. Like I brought my mom to Florida, and we were in the pool at this hotel. And people were like, wow, you're amazing to bring your mom with you and not just leave her locked up at a nursing home, and to bring her with you on this trip, because my mom was older. They're like, wow, you are amazing. It was other people that could see me and my mom. They were like, oh my God, you're really taking care of an elderly woman, a geriatric woman, and you're treating her like older people don't want to be treated like they're little old people. They want to be treated like they're still in the game. And that's what I did. And the gratification came from other people who would like suddenly say, wow, you're amazing. This is, you're doing a great job. As my own siblings would not give me that because they were jealous that I was willing to do it, and they wanted her locked up in a nursing home, and they ended up getting their way. I tried for 2.5 years to keep her out of a nursing home, and I did. I had to fight tooth and nail. Why weren't they just helping me? All they had to do was be supportive. I'd still be loving them. But to tear me to shreds, and then for PCT to take on that position of ripping me to shreds for doing the right thing by my mother and acting like I did a bad thing, you are not in your right mind, little Miss PCT, and I want my shirt back because you don't deserve it. And you also forced me to send it to you, and I wasn't a gift I wanted to give you. I gave it to you because you manipulated me with your masterful verbal skills. She is a master manipulator. She'll get anything she wants She will get anything she wants out of anyone with her wordsmithing. She's a wordsmith. She has like a PhD in wordsmithing. And that's a fact. She is a high-end wordsmith. I help an elderly man live independently to save him from going into a home. Wow, that's really nice of you. Hey, Nicka B, I'm sure he appreciates that. You love strongly. We can't expect others to feel. Jeez. Hi, Harvey. Good to see you, hon. Toshi, good to see you, darling. Your mom died at 52 of what Tina's mom has. What does Tina's mom have? Tina's mom is taking care of her husband who has cancer, and she's added her older brother. And she needs some support. Megan can't find it in her heart to go and give her mom a little loving and bring some meals and rub her back and just tell her she loves her and that, you know, just help her a little bit. I mean, it's a lot of burden on one old 83-year-old woman. That's a tough old bird, I'll tell you. Her mother's incredible. Tina has this masterful way of getting out of any responsibility by talking and describing all this shit. It's unbelievable. She did help me smile. She did. She helped me smile. She really was very nice. I really appreciate her for that. I needed that. Hey, Asher. Good morning, darling. Got that monkey off your back? For right now, I do. Her short-term memory is very convenient. Yeah. If she has such a short-term memory, why wouldn't she even remotely consider that maybe that's why she couldn't remember the $200 instead of calling me a liar? On the cop call, she was repeating some of your words. She, like, what? She was like, we were all sick of Bettina's BS and whining. You left Dolly's channel, too, because of PCT, constant need for attention, or calling you a troll. Wow. Cray, cray, baby. Cray, cray. Harvey's a mod on your channel. I want to be a mod on your channel. Thank you, Harvey. Mel, hi, darling. I'm going to give wrenches back, guys. If you guys would leave comments, my normal people, you know, under my thing, I can give you wrenches now. I can go back in the chat and give you guys wrenches. I don't need wrenches just yet. I think it's nice to just have a clean sweep, you know? Everybody the same, so nobody gets upset, you know, because it's just, it's like an energetic cleaning of the sweep, you know? Hey, Deets, good to see you, honey. Also, what makes you real is the fact that you are truthful about how your personal feelings played a role in this. You will also own and apologize when needed. Yes, I will. You know, I mean, thank you, BH. I thought it was good too. I teacup mama, darling. Everybody know how much I love teacup mama because she says magical boobs in this really funny, cute way that makes me smile and feel better. Magical boobs. If you ever feel upset, guys, before you hit the bottle, just say magical boobs and it just brings you up. It does. It works like a charm. Magical boobs, guys. Magical boobs. Look. Magical boobs. Boom. I got to say, we object to bullshit with my magical boobs. My oversized magical boobs. They are magical. Thank you. That was nice. It was her letting me talk. Thank you for letting me talk. Because I did. I just, you know, I needed to. There were things, and she let me do that. She was very gracious. It was really nice. I appreciate her a lot now. She's very pretty. Her eyes look right into that. Her avatar is really a good one because she looks right into the avatar is right in the camera. I felt like I was staring right at her. I was just looking right at her avatar, and I felt like her eyes were looking at me. It was amazing. You live in the Blue Ridge Highlands, where it was founded by the Scots. I've been learning about the Slavs. And their DNA and their genetics. I mean, I think that Savage and I probably have we're definitely cousins. You know, she looks like she's blonde blue. So good to see you guys. Coffee in hand. Yeah, the snowstorm. Yeah, I got the snowstorm too. Stop what? So nice not to have any negatives in here yet. If there is one, I'll. She is a pathological liar. Really, but she mixed it in with truth. She's a piece of work. Mama Bear. She hasn't jumped in the chat yet. Oh, who do you mean? Who's Mama Bear? She couldn't get that money back for that plane. Yeah, that was so nice. Her whole threatening, oh my God. Stiggy? Yeah, that Tina would say, well, you deserved what you get if my grant, something happened. She does not have the mother codes. Juliet, a lot has transpired between you and PCT. What would it take to ever speak again with her? I want my shirt back. Not damaged. And Savage Lives agreed with me and said that's what you got to do, send their shirt back. I was glad about that. You know, she doesn't want to send it back. I want the shirt, not the money. I want the shirt. Well, I don't know. I didn't call the cops on her. She called them on me. I did not expose her private messages. She exposed mine. I never called her a liar, other than she is a liar. She called me a liar, and I'm not a liar for a long time. I don't know. What do you think? What do you think? I know. I feel good now. Do you guys think I should make friends with PCT? Why would, after all the shit she said about me, why would she want me back as a friend? Oh, because I'm so generous and kind. I'd want me as a friend. I would. I'd want me as a friend. I wouldn't throw me under the bus. She was told not to say anything about the meeting. I find it hard to believe that if she saw Jimmy, she wouldn't say something about it. She would definitely say the truth. What could possibly happen at this point, you know? I think so too. I think so too, Gemini Mama. She says she's trying to keep the door open. She really still thinks she has a chance with them. She really does. So if they break up, she thinks she's proving her loyalty. I agree with that. Maybe Dolls and Duck was just trying to keep the peace and she was looking. I wonder. I heard she was getting reported or something. Yeah, her mask fell. And I'm glad that Savage likes my rants. That means a lot to me. If somebody likes my rants and my rambles and doesn't just attack me for it, we'll be in with each other, you know? I like it when people like my rants. The fact that she flew out there after PJ sent her the text tells you, because did she, what was the timing on that? When she sent the message and when she changed the ticket? I mean, it could have been after. She wants a vampire to start on Ernie's live. She didn't see him, but she had a warm time, Virginia. She stated on Ernie's live that she didn't see him, but had a wonderful time in Virginia. Then she said that he picked her up at the airport. That's a little harder to believe because I think he always has car trouble for one thing. And it's, you know, it's not like he's, I mean, picked her up in the airport with a rental car. I wonder. Yeah, I subbed her up too. I was going to send her $5. But then the thing ended before I could really get it going. I was going to send her $5 just to, you know, just for thanking her for having me and letting her just be me and her, which was really, really nice. Thank you so much. Thank you, Savage. Thank you, Savage. Thank you, Savage. It was really sweet. She was really nice. It was really good. She's Team Rose, baby. You're Team Rose. You're the cool, you're part of the cool club. Okay. He doesn't say anything because he opens his mouth about its attention to PCT. You don't interpret what he's thinking about her. No, why can't he say never met her, that she's crazy? I know. He did it for me. He did it to me. Hi, Leslie Ellswick. How are you, hon? Is that your real name? Because you used to have a different name. I recognize your picture. Dolly couldn't resolve the entire thing by saying yeah or nay if he met her. If I was PJ, I'd demand him to do that or leave. Yeah, she can't manipulate everyone. I'm on to her now. Yeah, she's very disrespectful. She doesn't care. She's like, I don't care. PJ was never nice to me. She absolutely does not care about, and you know, for a while I was like, well, I was trying so hard to be on her side and be a friend to her, you know? But I did say, you're not respecting Jimmy if you're not accepting this relationship, you know? I mean, I honestly could not believe she was still in love with Jimmy. I thought she was getting over it. I mean, oh yeah, Maria's awesome. True Team Rose. Yes, True Team Rose. I like the way that looks. I'm going to make some new t-shirts. Sorry, Rose. Say no when I were talking about the Thorpe. Oh, a rabbit hole no one should ever go down. Oh, what's that? True Team Rose. Thank you, Maria. That should be a t-shirt, right? I like that. I'm going to work on that. True Team Rose. It's for the us that don't need wrenches to be on Team Rose. who understand the wrench is, the wrench is actually a problem, you know, causes problems. Yeah. No, she's doing it for, she's doing it for attention. I was even Team Rose when you liked Tina and I didn't. Well, that's nice. Thank you. You're true Team Rose. You're definitely true Team Rose. That's nice. We're going to have the true Team Rose t-shirts. True Team Rose. We object to bullshit. True Team Rose. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, let's design a new t-shirt, guys. Thank you, Bob. I'm really happy. Thank you, guys. I am proud of my community. I have to say, I'm like, really great people on here who love me. This is really amazing. Thank you, guys. I really, you mean so much to me. I honestly, you've saved my life. Saved my ass. Thank you. Thanks for not caring about a wrench. I know, right? It's because you're a real human being and you're a real person. Look, the sun came out sort of for a second. See, just for a second, there's the sun. And the people who don't give a fuck about a wrench are the real people. Those are true Team Rose. True Team Rose. True Team Rose. I love it. I love you guys. I love you. You love the expression. Yeah, she does have mental health issues. I know. She is. True Team Rose. True Team Rose. Everybody write that into my comments. True Team Rose. Robert from the People's Porch has been found innocent. She was a liar. Oh, wow. I don't know that story. I believe on Queen Bee PCT said she paid for the shirt. I heard she sent me $35. I don't want $35. I want the shirt. And it's not that hard for her to send it. And I was going to give her son $50 if he would get that shirt and put it in a, I was going to send him $50 to send it to me, to go in there and get it and send it to me. I don't want her to have it. I don't want you to have it paper cut. It's not something you should have. Our friendship ended. You betrayed me in every possible way. You don't deserve to have a Team Rose, We Object to Bullshit t-shirt. And I don't want you to have something to just destroy and use against me in a witch's ritual. And I'm glad that Savage backed me on that. I know. I love Lucy too. True Team Rose. Cadence is good and easy to listen to. Who's Cadence? Succubus. Yes. Thank you, BH. Keep all the women and children safe and happy and healthy on this planet. God, not Lucy. I know. All right. You're right. I'll take away the I love Lucy. I will. True Team Rose, we object to bullshit. True Team Rose, with or without a wrench. Hell yeah, this is so cool. You guys are awesome. Anna Marie, Team Rose. Hi, Anna Marie. Selena is a natural human instinct. Selena, it's a natural human instinct to question whether someone playing mind games. Yeah, she is going to manage to win people over with the sob story and how mean everybody is to her. She's really, really fucking good at that. She is amazing. She's amazing. Magical boobies. I love the way you say that. It's so cute. You guys should hear her say that. I should have a recording. I should have everybody say magical boobies and magical boobs and then have a recording of everybody say it. Magical boobs, magical boobs, magical boobs, magical boobs. We all say magical boobs. Hashtag true Team Rose. It feels good to feel good, I must say. It, you know, because I was like, oh my God, it's the first day of spring. There's a snowstorm. You know, this all this shit's happening. It's this awful stuff. This friend of mine has just turned on me and then making it acting like it's my fault all over this thing about her mother. It's just like, what the fuck is going on? And but now I feel good. You know, I feel like, oh, the die's been cast. She starts for all attention. She wants to be like Madonna. She wants every, oh, now people are going to say this about me and that about me. All about me. See, I'm so abused. Ooh, I have had more trouble. She's a sucking attention ho. Attention ho, ho, ho. She's an attention ho, ho, ho. I loved breastfeeding too. Magical boobs. I totally did. I know. And where does the, and this thing, you cross the line. I am actually, no, she crossed the line. I of course you didn't lie. I know, I am the only one that stood by her at her lowest point. And she turns on me thinking she's gonna get what she wants. Okay, she wants more of it, I guess. Yes, fresh bread. That sounds so good. Who wants a grilled cheese sandwich? You heard yesterday that Joe was gonna be on Savage? What? Did she call Joe? What? She got a hold of Joe and I haven't even talked to Joe. I know. Oh, they liked me? Oh, good. Savage's chat did? Oh, good. I hope so. I know. A lot of people don't like her over there. It's not just PJ, too. Wait a minute. Joe's going to be on Savage before he's on mine? Well, whoever gets him first. If she did get him, and I doubt she called him, but if she did, I'd be there. I'd be amazed. Oh, yeah, she cries. She is so good. She's just like my sister. Yeah, she can talk for 24 hours straight. It's true. Looney Mooney. She's not ever going to send the t-shirt back. The first thing she wanted to say on QB's is, did you get the $35? Yeah, and I didn't. I haven't checked to see. And I don't want the $35. I want the shirt. She had barely a tremor. The whole thing's an act. The whole thing's an act. It's an incredible act. It's she loves to get PJ upset because PJ won. PJ got the man. My rent at Dolly Vision. I mean, it's supposed to be Dolly's channel, but you know. I don't think so. PJ likes me. Grilled cheese, chocolate cake, rant, repeat. 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 Yeah, I like it. I like it. Thank you, hon. I feel pretty good. I had a nice time with Savage. It was really nice. She's Team Rose, so... She understands the mother codes, and that means everything. Yeah, block while you can. Let me finish. She's always saying that. Aw, thank you, hon. I am glad, too. It was nice of her to offer me a chance to speak. I really... At first, she wasn't going to take sides, but then she said, I'm sure I'm Team Rose. Which, yeah, at this point, you have to take sides. She does think we should get to be friends again. I don't know. Hi, Pat. Glad you got a chance to speak freely without being interrupted. Thank you. Good to see you smiling, enjoying the talk. Thank you. Thank you, Pat. That means a lot. It was really, really good. She PCT's out of control. She turned on you so easily, Rose. I know. That's what... I didn't turn on her either. I was trying to get her to go see her mom. I would have helped her. I would have gone with her. I know it's hard to see your dying mom sometimes. She could have handled this behind the scenes. I know. I know. And also, she wanted me to go public with it. Go ahead. Go ahead. You've always wanted to take this public. And then she goes public. You're making grilled cheese for lunch? Do I want brie or smoked gouda? Ooh, I'll take cheddar. Thank you, hon. Continue with your classic simple dancing and educating with your awareness. Thank you, hon. Casey Cossico, Rose, I absolutely love you. You have a great personality. Thank you. That's sweet. Thank you, guys. She's been panel peddling. How do I stop her from doing that? It's really wrong for her to do that. Hi, PJ. You're doing the best impression jokes on her. If I had a higher voice, I could do her better. I was going to call you and just be like, she's really trying to manipulate you. She is trying to drive you crazy. She's hoping that you'll have all these doubts. And she's trying to create this mystery. It's all for clicks and views. It is all to make you feel insecure. She's really going after you that way. And she's hoping that it brings people to her channel to see if she'll say anything. What an actress. See the last 10 pages of what I sent you. PC's difficult future. We didn't do a thing. Yeah. Well, you're free. You're welcome to talk on my channel. Well, you know, it's the people. Thank you, Nene. Thank you, honey. How you doing, sweetheart? How's it going with your mom? Thank you, honey. I thought she was very nice and gracious and let me talk. And I had a lot to say and she let me say it, you know, Joyce, that was really nice of her and it was good. And I feel better. And that's, you know what, if you make an earth angel feel better, you just got yourself some bennies. You did. On a soul level, you've been upgraded. You have. And there is such a thing. I'm so hoping the summer's down and we can get back to our rows. You're at work listening. Good to see you, hon. Oh, Miss Rose, you look so beautiful, says Truth Hurts. Thanks, hon, and happy this morning. Hey, I feel so good to be happy. I was so unhappy yesterday. I was really down to the count yesterday. I sure wish all this mess could be left in the dust, dance, eat grilled cheesecake, let the magical booze be free. I love that comment. Yes, let's eat grilled cheese, chocolate cake, and let the magical boobs be free. Magical boobs. We object to bullshit. Let's all dance and be free and eat cake and have magical boobs dancing. Yeah, she's being very passive aggressive. And, you know, because you got Jimmy and she didn't. So she's got to make you feel as miserable as possible. That's what she's doing. I know. Well, I said, you know, in my video to Queen Bee, because I couldn't talk on panel. So I went and I made a separate video for her and hopefully she'll watch it. I don't know. I think she started to, but then TCT jumped in up there to get in the way of me speaking. See, Savage let me speak without TCT. No, no, that's not what happened. Listen. Let me finish with 1,000 pieces of information with numbers that don't have nothing to do with it. Let me finish. No, I didn't. No, I didn't. I mean, that's nice. That's nice. She doesn't want her to visit because she's annoying. It has, like, she goes off on drunks, but she hasn't been drinking. So I wanted her mom to see her not drinking. And she is. She's a covert narcissist. That's what her style is called, covert narcissism. Sub me up, guys, if you haven't. I hope you do. PJ showed Tina for who she really is. Yeah, we all did. And PJ could see it. She could see the other thing that PJ thought was that PCT was dangerous. And I didn't think she was. But now I'm like, oh my God. She threatens to beat me up, but wants me to fly there. She threatened to destroy my gifts. That's violence. She wants to cut everything up. She threatened to, she called the cops on me. She threatens a lawsuit and acts like, you know, it's like, I'm sorry, but she, and then I was like, oh my God, maybe she's dangerous. She did fly there. You were right. I didn't think she was dangerous. I did not know that side of her. I never, spooky girl. Thank you, hon. Thanks, sweetie. You were with him Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. I know. Playing dumb. I know. You can't stand. I agree. You want strong women around me. That's exactly how I feel. That's why I have so much respect for you. Because you are a strong woman. You're not playing some fucking game. You're not a big attention whore. You're not talking about bullshit just to build your channel. You actually know what's going on in this world. And you're an actual real mother. And a real daughter and a real, are you a grandmother yet? And you are a farmer and you run a farm and you know what the fuck is going on. I have so much respect for you. And the comments that you did at Steffer's, I was like, this woman knows her shit. We need to hear more from her. And you are right on. You are right fucking on. Stiggy, you would love Chaos and Roses. Good to see you, honey. Yeah, Stiggy would love Chaos and Roses as far as like all of that stuff. And, you know, knowing, understanding about the border and how badly we need controls there and how everything is just under this mind control bullshit, overly, you know, leftist, you know, Democrats gone wackadoo, losing their sense of what it means to be a free American, and this promotion of this, you know, communist this Chinese takeover. You know, this is, I object to it. I'm objecting to all of this bullshit. H of 79905. Hello, my dear. Good to see you, whoever you are. Oh, you were a block off? Yeah. She totally didn't. She doesn't care. What anger. Good, leave and don't come back. I won't miss you. She's not lying about meeting him. She doesn't even say whether she met him or not. She says she hasn't talked to him in a long time. I know, right? I won't get on panel with her. Never again. Never again. Unless she sends me my shirt back, and then I'll consider it if she really wants to. But there's no way I'm getting on panel with her. If she jumps up, if people let her up on a panel when I'm on there, I will jump down. I won't stay. And if I have more to say, I'll just get on my own live and say it. I respect my elders, but I would so slap the hoe out of PCT. Yeah, and you would have every right to. She is disrespectful. I know. PJ's been putting... See, I didn't see it that way. I was like, I thought she was getting over Jimmy. I really still find it shocking. I'm discussing how she spoke on QB. I know, asking Dolly seriously. Shocked. There's no excuse to that when you know someone's all is... When you know someone is together, and I'll keep saying she didn't listen to us. She won't listen to anybody but herself. She'll do whatever she wants. She's completely selfish. She even said that. She goes, I'm being selfish. She's said that. I think she's a great actress. Thanks, Melly C. Thank you. It all worked out timing-wise. Like, I was like, I hope that I don't get attacked. I hope that, you know, people don't disrespect my mom, and I have to put up with that. Because when people shit on me and my mom, It really brings me down, and it really makes me hate those people. People who try to attack me for my mom, they are out. They are out. It's just not acceptable. She's not a genius. Any mother that blocks food up from her son is not a genius. She's a hoarder. She's a really weird control freak. She's a really weird control freak. I know. It's really between them anyways. And she made 95 to transfer. Wow. Wow. Beautiful stonework. Where? What's beautiful? What stone? What did I show? I already forgot. My short-term memory. Oh, then Mel was on there. And Mel doesn't like me, so I don't know if she should talk to me, but she was on there with Tina, and she almost was acting like she understood a little bit about Tina. I mean, what's so weird is that Wild Angel was really against Tina, but now she's their friends again. We were thinking about BUFO, which is short acting ayahuasca. Oh. Oh, I have never heard about that. Giblet, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. This is a wonderful thing. You want to get a shirt? So when I call this guy, I'm going to go live and ask him if that's okay. She didn't listen to Ernie and then lied on him. She also, I couldn't believe this, but when she turned on Morbid, then he called her out. Why did you turn on me? Then he was getting on her case, but not as much as I thought he could have. And she controlled that. He could have really ripped her to shreds. And he somehow sounded like she kind of shut him up. And I was amazed by, I thought he's going to go in there and let her have it. No, she controlled that. She's incredible. She has this stubborn ballsiness with controlling things with her words. She's so relentless. Oh my God. Yeah. She's deflecting and she's rewriting and she's resetting everything to make herself look like the victim. And she's really fucking good at it. And it's just unbelievable. Hi, Lloyd. I heard Three Dog Day was going to Crime Con. He'll be there, the guy with the paper bag over his head. What's Three Dog Day? I know. Yeah, she acts like she's been secretly talking to him. Yeah, that's exactly how I feel. Bob says that, Rose, I honestly don't think she cares about seeing her mother. It's been years. If something happens to her mom, she will live with regrets. Maybe. I don't think she will. I think she doesn't want to see her mom. And she's going to pretend that, I'm an example of why you should go see your mom. It's been 13 years. And, she won't go. She doesn't give a fuck about seeing her mom. How dare you? What? Tell the truth? I'm sorry, but it's what I observe. I tried to backpedal with Ernie about what she said about Morbid. I know. Then she's in bad with both of them. And then Morbid's like, you have no loyalty. And he's like, let me teach you something, a few lessons about integrity. He's coming. And then she didn't know. No. She didn't let him speak. He didn't get to teach her the lessons on integrity and moral fiber. And I was like, this woman has no integrity or moral fiber. And talk so bad about Joe. I hate that. And lets any man on panel if they are drunk or and a skunk. That is true. She criticizes Joe for being an alcoholic, but she lets all these alcoholics on her panel. And I hate it when she shit talks Joe. I don't like it when people shit talk Ernie. I just cannot stand it. And I will not have it on my channel. And I feel the same way about Joe. I just can't stand him. I can't stand her shit talking him. I don't know why. I just know it's wrong. You know, I heard what Joe said. You know, he's seeing her now. He is starting to see her now. Poor Joe. I just, you know, I can't address something that never happened. I don't want him to. She would take it as a positive thing. It's really her disrespect for me, and I didn't wish you with. Ever, ever, ever. I got to talk to you, Maria. You're just so funny. Maria is the funniest. She says he's funny monologue. About what happened, and she's always like, I can't believe this. Oh my God. And she'll tell these stories. She leaves these funniest messages. Yeah, she's affected. I think she's MK Ultra. I do. I think she's MK Ultra. Hey, you're gonna try to make that for you today, Team Rose. What? Thank you. These are from my friend Dan. This is a cubic zirconia, and this is an amethyst. I got these both from Dan. This is an Indian ruby I got in 18 karat gold that I got to protect me from the lawsuit that I was forced into. Good to see you, Brandy. But she did go there. She just, patina, passive aggressive. Yep, patina. I think I've gotten over like the 2 weeks of, I've been in a state of shock that this happened, that this even happened, you know? Yeah, I like gold is my favorite, but sterling is the second favorite, right? All the lies, all the lies, and assuming I was lying, she's literally insane. Hi, Huntress, good to see you on. Where's your sidekick? She must have said Jimmy Dolly 100 times last night. Wow. I wonder if PCDLC see how her mom acts online. I think they do. I mean, she says they're all in their own rooms all day and she's alone all day. Then why are her kids there? You know, they just sit in their room all day. I mean, that is not a healthy situation. Hi, Max. Good to see you. So definitely wrong. Tony Fire. I respect your outlook on a person's relationship with your family. He's familiar. One only has one mom. You can get 1,000 men or lovers, but only one mother. You miss yours. Aw, that's nice. I miss my mom, too. Good to see you, Tony Fire. That's nice that you care about your mom. I miss my mom. I have to say I've been really missing her in the last 24 hours dealing with all this bullshit. And then the people attacking my mom and I? How dare you? You know, that's where that group of three people that attacks me and my mom. You know, you're just making me hate you. People that attack my mom and I. I've heard PCT station hadn't flown in 30 years or something, so I didn't believe she ever went. Really? I think she went. Didn't Maria pay for the hotel? Maria, didn't you pay for the hotel? I know. Why is Jimmy doing that? Little Red? I know. I Gator Man. Good to see you, hun. Thank you for just your comments the other night, because I'm with you. I think that a gift like that can kill you and can be designed to kill you. And very much, yeah, thank you for, you and I were thinking the same way on that subject. And we can talk about that. Said Morbid respects her later speak. That's because Morbid really, really likes her. But I think Morbid saw that she threw him under the bus for Ernie, then threw Ernie under the bus for Morbid. And she, either way, she just was completely just to both of them, you know? And yeah, she doesn't want Joe to talk to me. And I think that Joe and I both know that we can't talk because it'll make her crazy and we just can't risk it. We can't risk it. Like, so I'll never speak to Joe. I mean, I hope nobody tried to pretend they were me. I thought, oh God, I hope somebody doesn't send him an email thinking it's me and making me sound bad, because I have not emailed Joe. I do have a couple of 2-3 choices of emails that might be his, but I have not emailed him. I secretly keep wishing he'll email me, but he doesn't. So I don't think that, I think he's very upset about the drum thing with Ernie. Shell, I think that Joe was traumatized by the drum set, but Joe was a drummer. He was like a busy drummer, drumming in all kinds of bands and well-known bands. I mean, he left a whole list of it on my channel, which I can't find those messages. Hope he didn't take them off. But he wrote this whole thing about the bands. Joe is a professional drummer. He's the father. He is the father of his son. He wants to be the one to buy the drums. Joe did buy drums, 4 sets of drums for his son. Where are those? And he bought these drum sets for his very talented son, who is talented at drumming. He's the father, Joe, excited about his son's talent, went out of his way to spend money on his son's drum set to build his son's talent the way he has, that he shares with his son. And all of that is tossed so that, you know, the tiger looks like the big hero. And PCT is like, and Joe is like, what the fuck? I am the father. I bought him drum sets. Why are you elevating this other guy? What about me? I'm this father. I'm the drummer. I'm the experienced drummer. I have the DNA. I'm his father. I bought him 4 drum sets. Where are those drum sets? Why are you making this about some other guy? What is wrong with you, PCT? You know, he's just like, what the fuck? You're just acting like I'm nothing and acting like I didn't do anything when I had bought my son, our son, 4 drum sets. And you're just acting like I did nothing and elevating this. I get how Joe feels, you know? And Ernie was trying to do something positive. And Ernie was trying to respond to PCT acting like her son and all these problems. Ernie's like, she doesn't want her son fixed. She doesn't want her son to get better. She wants him to stay as if he's got a problem to keep that check. She said, we need that check. The 3 of them could all get a job. They're all adults. You know, her son's almost 30, her daughter is 20, and she is 60, 61. Every single one of them can work at Walmart, Walgreens, Whole Foods, the local supermarket, the post office. You know, there is so many jobs they could, all of any of them could do that would bring in more money. They don't. She wants them locked up in their little rooms, alone, on their computers, playing these stupid games with acting like I'm this bad person. The whole thing, it's ridiculous. Yeah, she does not want Joe. And Joe and I probably are never going to talk to please her. Just like my sister would control my relationships. We were like, she's going to lose it. She's going to go kill herself so we can never have a relationship. Obviously, you care about Joe still. PCT. But you don't give a fuck about anybody that, Dolly cares about. It's just bullshit. I'm just going to say it. I'm just going to say it. Well, I'm just going to say it. I'm going to say it right here. Well, I'm going to say it right here and now. Taming of the Shrew. I'd be a better Kate. Blanche from the Golden Girls. She was a hoe too. Hey, Will. Good to see you, hon. Glad you're here, Gator Man. I want to have a panel with you. Let's maybe we could do a panel later at late night or something like that. That'd be fun. Yeah. I know you, it's really hard to take care of your mom when she's aging like that. It is, it's every day your heart is broken a little bit more. And it's a very hard thing. And it's part of our life here. It's part of our job. And when you do it, then you will grow. And it doesn't last forever, you know? And it's, they need you when they need you. And being there is a very high honor. And I learned that from my mom. From how she treated her mother and then how I was able to rise to the occasion. And it was scary. Hi, Shasta. Good, honey. Good to see you, sweetie. Thank you, hon. I did get a lot of sleep yesterday. I was hiding under the covers the whole day trying to process the trauma of what PCT was putting me through and acting like it was my fault. It would be nice if he would say something. Mayor, good to see you. Klein, thank you, hon. Thank you, sweetheart. Sherry Ann. Love you too, babe. Good to see you, honey. I hope she gets what Ernie says, welfare check on her kids. She'll never. She hopes she gets 5150. You have so many blocks, it's very calm and relaxing. This is actually, the chat's going great. I am not having a bunch of haters in here. It's really nice. Thank you. 300 people here. Thank you, guys. Hope you hit the like. If you like, hit the like. Hi, just a small town girl. Good to see you, darling. I think this having no wrenches is working out, at least for now. Thank you, hon. Coconut oil, avocado oil, City Beauty, Derma Wand, and castor oil. That's my secret, even though, you know, the orchid you showed was so beautiful. You never bought them. Scared I'd kill it. I should show you the way they look tonight, right now. Very beautiful. It is, and that was a spectacular one. I haven't bought flowers in a long time. Richard's been sending me gorgeous bouquets of roses every couple weeks, which has been amazing. So, and God, Richard, I swear you do save the day many, many times for me. She wouldn't let you talk on Ernie's. She won't let anybody talk. No one will ever get to talk if she's there. Thank you. Thank you, Savage, for letting it just be me and her. It was really nice. I don't think they did see each other. I think she's just pretending. Spring is rebirth, Rose. Today you are resetting and blooming. A shift, if you will. I sense it. You have a glow today. Thank you. I feel it too. I do. Thank you. I feel it. I know. It was a combination of sleeping for 2 days or hiding. I don't know. It seemed like it was either a day or it was like a good day and a half. I was like, I need to, I have to de-stress. I got to get away from all of this, you know? And after I made my video to cute Queen Bee, and then I was just completely off my game. And I think it was a whole 2 days because it was like she was going to do an interview, but I missed it. I never showed up for 4:30 because I didn't see it. Then it was 7:00. And then she was going to play my video and respond to it. But then PCT gets in there and takes over. So she never probably even saw it. 83 likes. Oh, okay. I'd love more likes if you want, guys. I know. Dolly and her sister. I know. I bet she has been Baker acted. 84. You're going to save it good. Yeah, it was good. I thought it was nice. I felt good about it. I felt nice. It felt so good to have just be heard, you know, and just to have to be relaxed and have a one-on-one. And, you know, it was really, really nice. She's great. She was great to me. Aaron. Thank you, Will. Good to see you, hon. Thank you, sweetie. Thank you, Teacup. I love you guys. You know, she's, you don't think she's team PCT, she's team truth and facts. Well, I mean, she might have an understanding of, I think she actually, I didn't see it, but somebody said that she apologized for letting PCT up when I was up, and that she didn't know that I was get triggered by PCT's face and voice, and that she would like to give me a chance to speak without PCT. And I appreciate that. And I would take her up on that. But I would rather do one-on-one with her, because she's got people in her panel that don't like me, and I don't think will ever let me finish and talk where I can just relax without having to get, like, you know what I mean? I think Dolly was trying to tell her in a really gentle way that he was with PJ. That's what, and she just, Tina's like, I don't care. Thanks. Thank you, hon. Catelyn is super nice. Super nice. She's really sweet. She and Maria G have just nice. They're just, I mean, I'm sure that, you know, they, you know, she did have a friend like Maria G. Yeah, I believe you. Positive Team Rose is the most wonderful version. You're such a good man, Gator Man. You're really a cool dude. I really like you a lot. You're very, you got your head on straight. Angela Witt, A Rose for Rose. Crazy Nurse, Rose, go read Crimes and Fashions community posts. You will love it. Really? Let me just do that really quick. Hold on. Crimes and Fashion. What's new, Pussycats? In a shocking turn of events, Crimes and Fashion has officially switched her allegiance from PCT and is now throwing her support behind Team Rose. Oh, wow. Several factors were considered when making this very important decision. Wow. Can you guys hear me? I don't want to miss out, but can somebody call me if you can't hear me? I want to read this. Oh, boy, this looks good. She switched sides. Yeah, PCT chose Lionel and Blank over me, and that was very hurtful to me. You've experienced a traumatic event with your mom. I could feel your heartache. This is what I said to Tina. It's a bad thing to pull up a shame on Tina. I agree. Thank you, Maria. You're a human being, and I highly value your friendship. Mom's been gone 11 years and 9 days. Aw, I'm sorry, babe. Yes. Yes. Boy, I'm excited about this. You guys want to see this? I'm going to put it in the chat. I want to read this. I just want to make sure you guys can hear me, because sometimes I can't hear. Here's the thing. Oh, boy. I did acting at our civic theater. Oh, you're the one who can sing, too. And my youngest daughter, I love theater. I think that's why I gravitated to your channel. You remind me of a Renaissance woman. Oh, I love that. Thank you, babe. Can you guys hear me? I don't want to miss out on any of these comments. I'm way behind. Oh my God, I'm so behind. Can you guys hear me? I'm jumping way ahead, hoping I can see. Oh my God, wow. Look at all these comments, guys. Oh my goodness, wow. Oh, I hate to miss anything. Wow, shit. Oh my God, there's Luna Moon. Luna Moon. Mrs. MG Flat, you guys can hear me? Okay, good. You want me to read this? Okay, good. You want me to read this? Okay. I want to read this to you guys. All right. I want to read this to you guys. Okay. Several factors were considered when making this very important decision on who to dust off my pom-poms and cheerlead for and or hate watch in their ongoing social media battle, including the following in parentheses, not necessarily in order of appearance. One, sympathy and concern for all of the potential ramifications of Team Rose's DNA material being in the possession of someone who could possibly, allegedly, and for entertainment purposes only, use her genetic material to conjure spells and various black magic, white magic, satanic magic ceremonies that are rituals. Yes. Thank you. I like her. There's Queen Bee. Queen Bee's alive. Number two, overall ability to quench each of the individual's opponent's thirst for attention at all costs. In parentheses, at PCT. I was on your team when all this began 876 years ago. But girl, you should have quit while you were ahead. Like, I don't know, maybe 85,593 panel appearances ago, because the more you talked, well, the more you talked, and the more you talked, the more I learned, in quotes. Oh, wow. Wit, number three, which of the opponents actually seem to have any form of loyalty to anyone, i.e. morbid panel debacle, and parentheses, and does not shift loyalties like the winds of change blow simply in an effort to be more relevant and to get more eyes on them? Which of the opponents understands or realizes that there is life, that there is life after YouTube, and or appreciates any real word flesh and blood humans that do not appear as avatars with synonyms, aka screen names, in parentheses, for the ones in the back, because that was sort of a big word and I'm nothing if not a helper, end parentheses, and or cares about anything but attention, in parentheses, this one was a no-brainer, pun very much intended, end parentheses, crying, laughing so hard. Number four, which of the opponents looks better in tiger stripes? Y'all know I love some animal print, and or enjoys or endorses the consumption of turtle soup, toss up. So this was a wash decision made by coin toss. Oh my God. Number five, which opponent actually understands that they are making a complete jackass out of themselves on the daily for and making fun of all YouTube suffer through their nuclear meltdowns over what is possibly the dumbest thing on earth to be arguing about? And yes, I am very much aware what it says about me and you, because you all know you are watching this shiz show every day too. So save it, Sister Christian. This one was a no. Oh my God, I'm not kidding. For all the reasons stated above, Crimes and Fashion is officially hashtag Team Rose, but ladies, please stop the bleeding and hashtag PCT. Instead of bringing sexy back, why don't we bring dignity back? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Team Rose, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Awesome. Awesome. Hope she subbed me up. I guess I'll sub her up now. I just subbed her and liked it. Thank you. Well, I don't know why it took her so long, but hey. Oh my goodness, guys. Oh my goodness. I missed all these comments. I miss Ann Horn. Penny, thank you. I am too. I'm really grateful to her for allowing me to do that after in all this mess. And I'm glad people are wanting to bring dignity. I'm rooted in ethics and moral fiber. And I am loyal, you know, to a fault, you know, you have to earn it. But I mean, I'm not, you know, I really tried to stay loyal to her as much as I could. It was when she betrayed me repeatedly for 6 to 8, 9 days that I know the processed food is bad. The drugs are bad. You know, there's a lot. Thank you, Rainy Cat. And I pride myself on that because it's something I really had. I had it in me and I rose to it. I had it in my DNA and I was able to activate that DNA. And I want my shirt back. And does that sound dignified? Honestly, in this case, it is, because she threw it all in my face. Everything I did for her, she threw it in my face and acted like I didn't do enough or anything. I mean, I missed a lot of comments here, but I don't know if I can go back and grab those comments now. I don't think I can, which is honestly too bad. Because I would like to go back and see those comments. So, but anyway, well, I guess I'm going to, I want to see what you guys said. And now I don't know what to do. I want to go back and you, there's a lot of comments there. Anna Marie, Luna Moon, Steph V. I'd fight for freedom from that if PCT were my mom. That's interesting. Leon may want to have mama. I feel happy now, guys. The sun came out. Look, look, look. The sun came out. You know, I feel like I can go shovel and get a little outside time. Maybe I can make a video of the outside or the snow-covered town. I could walk around and do a video for you guys or something, you know. Her birthday. I feel hopeful. Read Lean On Me's comment. Which one? Where? Can I get back to it? Can't find it. Food is very important. It's everything. Look, the sun's coming out, guys. I feel happy. I finally feel happy. It's been so long. She's never seen me in Tiger Stripes. I don't know. I mean... I missed the comment. Luna says, I've been in the bushes for most of this issue with Teen. I wanted to stay neutral, but the past two lives with Queen, she managed to make me sick. I was pretty upset. I was sickened as well. I was like, you know what? I only could tolerate it last night, like in the early morning, when I finally got up like around 3:30 or something, and I was listening to it, and then I was making coffee, and I was like, okay, this thing's at 10. I gotta get ready, you know, get ready, and I had a shower at 9 to make sure, like, you know what I mean? I was ready by 10 and I was just ready by 10. I was very glad that I made it and that I felt like I could handle it because I was like, really listening to her lie about me upsets me so deeply because I cared about her so much. And I really believed that she was my real friend, that she would never ever think that I would lie to her. You know, I would never send her a shirt of mine or anything with my DNA on it if I thought she was going to hurt it or use it in a satanic ritual. No fucking way. So when she, but last night I was finally able to listen to it through Easy's live, which I was enjoying until he turned on me. And Richard, thank you, honey. And you have everything to do with that. Yeah, really, Tony, you shut up. Oh my God, I know. I know. I felt the same way. I couldn't handle it until early in the morning. I couldn't listen to her voice anymore. I was like, I cannot listen to this woman. If she's shit talking me, I just have to shut it out. I have to just hide in my room. I have to just, I don't know, you know, just, and it exhausted me. So I stayed away from the whole thing. And then I finally was listening. I was like, oh my God, this woman is incredibly manipulative. Yeah, she's a real bullshit artist. That's why she doesn't deserve the shirt. She doesn't object to bullshit. She's a bullshit artist. Get it? Get it? Oh my goodness. Hi, Mac B. Jen. Oh yeah, I gotta show you the bouquet that I got from Richard. Although I did show it. Yeah, that's not nice. Don't be mean to her. Don't be mean to each other. Guys, here's your chance to block each other where you're not affecting the channel. So go ahead and block people that are mean or cruel to you in any way. You can go ahead and make so you cannot see those people. You do not have to fight with those people. Just get rid of them. Katie says, Rose, PCT made it very clear she's not sending your shirt back. She's not sending you anything back. I don't want that. I want the shirt. Hey, Wind. Guys, you want to... Is this the song or is this a different song with the same similar opening? Rachel? It was par for the course when she called Mav's phone and he was on Miss Ann's panel, me, me, me. It is. It's me, me, me. She's like a little child. Thanks, Klein. Good to see you. Harvey Blevins. Who's this? She's getting a free pack and play. I have a pack and play. Oh, that's sweet. Oh, wow. That's great. So my daughter just said that she got a free pack and play that she can leave at my house. I think she wants to come up more often and just, I have the mattress to the pack and play. They're coming up soon, actually. So that's sweet for her to say, because I think, you know, that's sweet. My daughter's really, I have wonderful children. I have really, really wonderful children. I really do. I always said my kids were the best thing I did. I'm sorry that I thought you were the root of the problem, but when someone doesn't hear you, it's a natural reaction to scream to get the point across. Thank you, Penny. Thank you, Penny. Thank you so much. Rose, your interview went so well. Just got done listening. Thank you. It was really nice. It was great. And everything else has been said. You went up there and she ran? I know, she did run from PJ. What, you? So you can cry and Tina can't, your cry is, Rose is fake. No, it isn't. My cries are real, because I don't like fake crying. I actually was never really good at it. I wish I was. Hey, tattooed angel, honey. Good to see you, darling. How are you doing, sweetheart? I know, I blocked that person. I think it's good for us to have a couple days where we can block people that we don't like and personally, and then I can block from the channel myself, and then I get the fun of doing the blocking since that was done to me so many times and now I get a chance to do it. Lean on me, must have left, but she said because of you, she decided to forgive her mother and go see her. Wow. Thank you for telling me that. She did? Aw. See, this was worth it. Gosh, see? This was worth it. I'm so happy. Good for her. Good. Good for me. Good for her. She's sweet. She decided to forgive her mom and go see her. Gosh, that makes me feel good. You don't block anyone because you're a nosy bitch. That's how I feel, too. I like to see what everyone's going to say. Wow. Thank you for telling me about Lean On Me. Thank you for telling me that. I got to find that comment. I want to put your comments in my book. I think I'm going to go look for your comments. You sent me a message that means a lot to me on your Facebook. Okay, honey. We don't want to see your cat meet her and her meat with her perfect little diction. God, this is quite the manipulator. I'll tell you what, poor Joe didn't have know what the hell fucking happened. You know, he just can't believe it. He's like, I get he's in shock. I feel bad that I can't be a support for him, but she'll make life worse for him. And you know, I don't want to do that to him. I'm just going to love you from afar, Joe. And I do think you're a good man based on not just the sound of his voice, but the things that he said, you know? He's really sweet. He's a sweet guy. He's a nice guy. I want to get a bunch of the comments today and put them in my book. Oh, Dolly went live. Thanks, hon. Rose, BJ sent me a message. Okay. Gotta go read your messages. I want to put some of your comments in my book. Sometimes you guys say things to me that means very much to me. Like if you say that because of me, you went to go see your mom. Let's see, I can put this in the sunlight. That means a lot to me, guys. That means a lot to me and the mother goddess. And let me tell you, the mother, the earth that you're on under your feet, that you live on and that we are using to survive and have this life experience, she will love you. If you love her, the earth herself, and love the mother, love your mother in any way you can. Anything you can do to love your mother, you will be rewarded. She loves that. She needs us. She needs us to love her. It is awesome. 3 grandbabies at once. Are they coming or you already have them? You're so blessed. You're very blessed. You're a powerful woman. Chaos and roses. You're an amazing woman. You've been through a lot. She's been through a lot. Oh, there you are. It would be very healthy if I go. It's been weighing on me really bad, but you helped me. Aw, thank you, honey. Just love the earth under you, and she will give you the strength to give you what you need to go see your mom. So start with the earth under your feet. Communicate with her. Draw her energy into you as you give your energy to her to process. It's a relationship being on this planet. It's a relationship between us and this planet. We're in the stuff the planet is made of. Your body represents the planet. So when you connect with the planet, with your feet on the ground, you get those earth codes, you heal. And then you ask her for the support you need to make peace with your mom that benefits both of you. Your mom matters too. And this is beautiful. Oh, it is the best to be a grandma. I'll tell you, Grandma Club. My boy will be 22 on the 26th. He's fourth year of college. Good for him. All children are safe, happy, and healthy on this planet. I feel so much better. Oh, that's okay, guys. Thank you, guys. You guys are awesome. Aw, thank you, honey. I have amazing women in here. And some good guys. Mel! My darling, I haven't seen Litka. I have to catch up on some of her emails, so. 3 grandbabies coming? Sister's voice is having 3 grandbabies coming? Oh my God, who's having 3? I can't keep track. Just congratulations. All of you guys that are getting grandchildren, congratulations. Oh, I know, her whole psychology, it's so much like she's a combination of 2 of my sisters. Your grandmother would have been 101. My mom would have been 92 if she'd lived. I know. I think her mom's pretty badass, actually. Her mom is an incredible woman. Maybe she was cold or something, you know, maybe. Or she took some meds that she thought were okay, but actually made her daughter into a weird, subtle sociopath or something. I don't know. I know. My mom's ashes are in my attic. Yeah, her mom's alive and she won't go. Some people, narcissists don't like to face death. They don't like aging. That'd be great. I'm praying for a wonderful reunion that feels good for both of you, whatever that is. And honestly, draw your power and your strength from the earth. It is there. The codes of strength, rejuvenation, and regeneration are right here in the flowers and in the earth, in the waters, in the plants, in the vegetables, in the grass under your feet. It's right there. The strength is in her. The body represents the mother. This is where we need to love and connect and rebuild our relationship with the mother goddess and the great mother. And while we're on earth on the mother, our life gets better as we rebuild our strength and power in honoring the mother and the grandmother. Your oldest girl's 30. My son is 28. My youngest is 23. Very similar to me. My oldest is 33, my son is 29, and my youngest is 22. So we're very close. 4 grandbabies. They thought there will be more babies in the next few years. You are very lucky. Four grandbabies. Oh my goodness. Your mom is 92 at the moment, Harvey. You're so good to your mom. Grilled cheese sandwiches. I wonder if she was MK Ultra. You know. Ah, the snow is melting. It's falling down. Your grandma would be 103. Oh my goodness. Rose Rambo has the positive energy for Mother Earth to send out healing to Ernie. He recovered quite nicely. Thank you. Thank you for saying that, because that's true. I did a whole healing on him on Sunday, and he really bounced back. He was taking the oils. He was taking cayenne as well, all the stuff that I told him to take, and he bounced back hugely. He was really flying. He was, like, back on track. He was back to Ernie, the Ernie I originally fell for, the Ernie that cares about the trafficking, that was on the ball getting the damn job done. That was the Ernie, and he was all energetic, and he was staying focused, staying calm. You know, I know. It was like, oh my God, am I on a new timeline with the old Ernie? Is like back in the swing? Like, what the hell? This is amazing. You know, thank you for acknowledging that I did do a healing on him, because I did. And your mom passed away at 45 on March 5th, the day this started with y'all. Really? Sorry, babe. Really? I'm so sorry, babe. That's very recent. I'm at work. I just called. She said, come over, honey. Come on over, honey. Really? Aw, your mom? Of course she wants to see you, babe. I want to hear about it. You should do a video. A lot of people were inspired by me and my mom back then. Aw, that's sweet, honey. Chaos and Roses is the mother of us all. She's got the real mother grandma code. She's got the mother codes. He's wonderful. He's wonderful. I'm going to probably see him today. You guys are amazing. My mom's 2-year anniversary of her death was on Monday. Oh, wow, hon. So that was 3 days ago. I'm sorry, babe. Well, I'm sure she's very proud of you, honey. I'm sure she's very proud of you. And now you are the elder, and you definitely can take that on, because you have that, you have those, that strength and those mother codes. She's awesome. Chaos and Roses is, I've got so many cool women on here. Yes, gardening. Gardening, guys. So far, it's a very good day. It's March 21st. I guess it's the first day of spring. Here's the sun. I'm gonna get Richard's roses and show you. They're so pretty, guys. I almost feel like celebrating. I feel so happy. I feel like celebrating. So look, let's see. Hold on. Turn this around. Look, these are from Richard. Look how beautiful these are, guys. Are these not gorgeous? Master, are they not beautiful? Remember when I Dream of Jeannie spoke like that? I should go out and shovel while the sun is shining and get some fresh air. Come back with some renewed energy, you know? So nice to spend time with you guys, honestly. I'm sorry, hon. Penny says, my husband was diagnosed with lung cancer at age 48 and passed away. Aw, hon. I've experienced so much explosive anger at times. I can understand that, hon. Your anger is justified. Your anger is justified. My mother would definitely support you in honoring your anger and expressing it. And don't try to stop it or squelch it. I mean, do it in a healthy way, you know. It's hard. We need to understand how to love, how to deal with the anger. Your older brother says you're bossy and bitchy, but you know what? You're justified. You got to be bossy and bitchy sometimes. I get it. I honestly get it. It's hard to be a mother. It's hard to be the woman. It's hard to be the one everybody counts on to produce everything. You're getting a major blizzard. You just got news. My brain ear tumor has shrunk massively. Wow, Wanda. Hi, darling. We're blizzarding majorly. Wow. Wow. Oh my goodness. Look at the snow. Wait. And the roses. Your brain tumor shrunk? Hell yeah. This is amazing. They are. They're gorgeous. Orange enough. Oh my God. Look at these. Look at these. They're fantastic. They're like sorbet or sherbet. They're beautiful. I absolutely love them. They were very excited about them too. She has to take responsibility for her actions. I don't see her doing that. I see her planning this campaign to try to make me look bad. That never will never end. Give been in therapy for a while. Now putting my child at peace. So finally I'm really ready. Wait. What? They are breathtaking. Did you what? Wait, did you lose a child lean on me? There's a lot I don't know. I know. I never got glasses. I mean, but you can rebuild your eyes. I haven't had a relationship with my mom for years. I love my children and grandchildren. They're my angels. That's nice. You know, you can just be the mom. And my grandma and my mom's name are both Rose has chaos. Really? And a granddaughter with middle name Rose. Aw, I've been surrounded by roses my whole life. Wow. That's really sweet. I'd love to see pictures of them sometimes. I'd love to see your family. You know, we're not allowed to show the kids, but I'd love to see your mom and your grandma. Because I know you're beautiful. You did show me some. You're very gorgeous. You have a beautiful family. Yeah. Well, I'll try not to make it too long. So your mom was a single mother being... My mom was a single mother being my dad. My dad was murdered by his girlfriend when you were young. Oh my God. She raised me to be the kind, compassionate, empathetic woman I am today. She's my whole world. Ah, that's sweet. That's really nice. You're the one Ashley I actually like. So many Ashleys, it's hard to get along with. Ashley Y finally has been nice to me and she won me over. You have been through my, you'll have to have an interview with you, honey. I need to learn more about you, babe. Besides the fact that you're a talented comedian. True Team Rose Gator, man. I'm going to have to get you a t-shirt. I'm going to do the men's shirts. Do you want the men's shirts that say we object to bullshit or True Team Rose or both? Savage Lives. Do you want to see? You want, here's the link. She had a lot of people watching. And here's the link. There you go. So you guys can watch that too. And can you suggest something to help me fall asleep and something for energy? You mean food-wise or music-wise? You went to grief counseling. Almost everyone was 70 and above. Oh, wow, Penny. Really? I have a short on my computer page with the kids. Oh, you do? Okay. All right. I got to go check that out. I'll be giving wrenches back so you guys can put in links. You lost your 20-year-old daughter at 14 months ago. Oh, honey. I'm sorry, babe. Really? Oh, honey. I'm so sorry, babe. Drunk driver. I am so sorry, sweetheart. I am so sorry. That is painful. Oh, my goodness. Oh, your grandma was so stunning, Rose. She was a nurse, a singer, played about every instrument. You have such a talented family. Good God. His death was covered up by Ellie, but that's a... Wow, you have to tell that story. I cannot believe what you guys go through. PCT just to back off Rose Ramble. I agree. PCT is a very manipulative individual. Yes, she is. She likes word salads. Yes, she does, and she's an expert at making them. That doesn't fly with me. We got this, Rose Real. Thank you, honey. Have a beautiful day, Rose. Going outside. I will. You're going outside. I'm going to play in the garden with the sun out, too. Well, you're pretty strong, Anne. You're doing good. You guys are awesome. I'm so glad you were here, Chaos, because I really wanted to talk to you and tell you that I thought you were amazing and that I would love to hear more from you. And let's talk more about everything. And thanks for being here for me, guys. Starvation, SASB addiction, dolly, domestic violence, along with kidnapping, two house fires, death of a child. Oh, honey. 34 times cancer, survivor, broken back, and was a wheelchair bound, but I'm a survivor. Oh, my God. Are you serious? You went through all that? Two house fires, death of a child. That's the worst one, honey. Oh, my goodness. We got to talk. You lost your 19-year-old nephew to a drunk driver. My brother and his wife will never sing. Oh, honey. It's only 33. I need sun, too. I'm sorry, guys. You guys have been through so much. Big hugs. Big hugs. Cyber hugs. Cyber hugs. Magical boobs. Magical boob hugs. Quick. Magical boobs. Quick. Let me give you a magical boob hug. Magical boobs. Hug, hug, hug. Cyber hug. Gosh, guys. Bob Raymond. So glad the thing is shrinking, though, sweetheart, for you. Hi, Kylie. I don't know how you smile either, lean on me. We're going to have to interview, girl. Kid, you want to do an interview sometime? You sound like, I would love to hear your story. It's good to process. Good God. Thank you, hun. You're a role model. You're a role model that we need. Magical booby hug. Yes, that's right. We need the good women role models. You're amazing, Lena. I mean, I had no idea you've been through all that. I have no idea. I'd love to interview you. Well, let's set up something. TeamRose4848@gmail.com. Love those boobies. Magical hugs. Big jugs. Magical hugs. That's what the t-shirt should say. Big jugs, magical hugs. For big-breasted women like me. Big-breasted booby women like me. I know, that's true. Magical boobs. Sure, that'd be great. Yeah, we'll do panels. We'll have one-on-ones. It'll be great. Thank you, guys. Thanks for being here. Let's go out in the sun while we got the chance. Magical boobs hugs. Magical boobs. What is it? Magical jugs. Magical hugs. Magical jugs or something. What was it again? All right. I see you soon, guys. She is beautiful. She's amazing. Magical boobs. Say magical boobs a lot when you feel depressed. I'm telling you, it brings you right up like that. It's like chocolate. Magical boobs. Chocolate. Magical boobs. Great to see you guys. You're all wonderful, incredible women. And we're winning this bitch. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. And thank you again to Savage Lives Media for making my morning become the nice morning that set me off to a good day and made us all feel good. And she's Team Rose. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Hug those jugs. That's what it is. Hug the jugs. Want a hug with my magical jugs? Guys, come up with phrases to bring next time. I'm going to write things down. How about some hugs with my magical jugs? How about this? How about some hugs with my magical jugs? These are big ass boobies. Magical hugs with magical jugs? Question mark. All right, guys, I'm going to fly. Love you. Thanks for being here. Magical jugs, magical hugs. Love you. Love you.